not, but you're all here because you were invited, because you were nominated for a SOAR Award, which means someone has recognized you for doing an excellent job and going above and beyond the scope of your position. So these gentlemen are going to go ahead and read the nominations and get up there.
Thanks, Jen. Thank y'all for making the time to be here, and congratulations to every single one of you on being nominated for the SOAR Award. We have Bob Berg, County Commissioner, with us today. We're very glad to have Bob here, and Bob makes it a habit to attend these, and we all appreciate it. And we have Bruce Walker and Sherry Hook, also Assistant County Managers. They're going to help us read out these nominations. So with no further ado, Bob, do you have anything you'd like to say to the folks?
Well, let me wait until the end.
Okay.
I'll say something then.
All right. Well, as we go through these, we'll call your name out and kind of read the nomination form and the information that's been provided by either the public or one of your peers or your supervisor, and we'll ask you to come up and shake our hands and get a picture taken with us for the website. So, Bob, if you'd like to lead us off.
We'll put those up on the dartboard.
That's right.
Hope everybody washed their hands.
No. We have a really good health record.
We do.
Cindy Royston, Alamance County Veteran Services. Cindy and the office did a wonderful job for me. She took care of me and answered my questions. She was very knowledgeable about what she was doing and returned all of my calls. Very helpful to me and very patient with me. That was one quote. Another quote, everyone in the office did a great job and I appreciate what they did in helping to process my claim. You have a good crew in Graham and the Veteran Services offices.
Aw, that's
nice. So you want a pose picture?
Yes, we get a, you want to get a picture?
Come on. Wait, there's certificates underneath.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
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 Thanks.
Congratulations.
All right, so our next nominee is Karen Hall from the Alamance County Health Department. And the nomination form reads, I am nominating Karen Hall for the SOAR Award because she gives excellent customer service and is knowledgeable in all of her job duties as the vital record switchboard operator, as well as processing assistant in the clerical field. Karen goes above and beyond in her job duties to assist our patients, both in person and over the phone. She is a great listener and will try her best to find a solution to help our patients. She assists many people in the community, such as the funeral homes and public, for birth and death certificates. She has a passion for the Red Cross. She helps coordinate appointments for the blood drives and helps to prepare or assist in many ways with the setup of the blood drives at the health department. Karen is caring, thoughtful, and goes the extra mile. When she hears a child crying in the health department, she will come out of her office and talk with the child to get their mind off what is troubling them. Most of the time, the child is no longer crying when they leave her at Karen Hall.
Nick Batten, Stephen Scott, and Jesse Ayers. These guys were great to assist with the setup and the cleanup of our recent wellness fair. They were so helpful. They came and loaded stuff for the fair and our committee and helped unload everything at Graham Recreation Center. They were the best and always willing to help. We could not have done all that we did that day without their help. These guys worked so hard and they're such hardworking individuals that sometimes are just underappreciated. Just wanted to thank them for all they do and to keep us safe. How many of these you got?
Three.
Three?
Pretty good.
Come on in.
Got three of them.
You can fix my plumbing.
The next person is Terry Rudd from the Health Department. She is highly amazing at her job. She is the only one that made me feel important. She is excellent. We also spoke on a personal subject. She encouraged me and kept telling me that I could do anything that I set my mind to. She is a wonderful and amazing woman. Terry.
Inspections department. So here's a quote. I pull permits for our company all over the USA and find it rare to experience such a pleasant, helpful, and courteous staff. Your building department rocks. That image, I don't know. I greatly appreciate Amy's help. Also noted that Amy was both knowledgeable and attentive in resolving the concerns of the client. So congratulations.
Thank you.
So our next nominee was Edwina DeRosa, Alamance County Passport Services. And the nomination form reads, from leaving her a message on her answering machine, calling me back with promptness and giving extreme details on how to handle my concerns, to meeting her in her office with a smile and a wealth of knowledge to relieve my concerns, Edwina absolutely went above and beyond her duty in helping me to apply for my passport. She explained in detail all the questions that I asked and did it all with such a wonderful attitude. I can only say that we need more people like her in this world. Giving recognition to her is just a very small part of what she truly deserves. Edwina?
She's not here.
Okay. We'll be sure and get it.
John Albajali. John has gone above and beyond during our phone transition at EMS. We had several phone issues at the beginning of the process. Jod spent many hours with us making sure that everything was exactly the way we needed, no matter how big or small our need was. Not only was he knowledgeable, but also very friendly and nice. MIS is very lucky to have someone like Jod on their team. Absolutely.
My skill.
Okay, this one is for Brian Baker, John Gus, Kyle Decker, Alamance County Recreation Department. And this is from an email that was sent to Brian Haygood. Dear Brian, your generous offer to provide transportation to the visitors from Mexico allowed them to travel safely and in style to and from RDU. Brian Baker was very accommodating, even when we had to change the departure date and their hotel destination. John Gus was especially nice, and Kyle, the driver, became a new friend. Mm-hmm. We deeply appreciate your support for our Sister Cities program. Sincerely, Sandy, which is the Vice President and Liaison for Mexico. And Brian stated, when originally asked if the county could assist with the Sister Cities visit, I immediately thought of our Parks Department folks because I know all of you place a great value in serving or whatever need or opportunity comes available.
This will work. I just want to say on that last one for the Parks and Recs, I serve on the Sister Cities Board, and you guys got a lot of accolades at the board meeting that followed your service, so thank you very much. Really well, much appreciated. Okay, this goes to Leslie Brown from Social Services. Is Leslie here? Yes, here is. Okay, I just want to give Ms. Leslie Brown recognition on my child support case. The client also noted that Leslie was both courteous and respectful while clearly explaining how to address her needs and concerns as well as the department's policies. On a different nomination form, a client said, and I quote, Mrs. quote, Bulldog Brown, in parent locate interest aid, is a real, quote, bulldog who takes pride in her career. She's very thorough and persistent where no one else seemed to care. Others spoke as if my mission was impossible, but Ms. Brown made my case a priority and respected the fact that I'm doing what's best for my child. Congratulations. Okay, so this goes to the winner of the quarter, is it?
Yes.
Okay, and this goes to, well, let me just read it first, and then we'll say his name at the end. We recently changed the entrance to our office building and are now required to come through the civil court doors. Daily, as I come and go, Mr. Janey acknowledges me. Well, I just gave it away. That's fine. He greets me by my name and always gives me a warm welcome as well as words of encouragement. One morning, I noticed that those words of encouragement were not just for county staff. As individuals entered through security, he spoke with such respect and compassion. This morning, the man in front of me looked a little rough around the edges and was not so well put together. Mr. Janney shook this man's hand and addressed him as sir. This guy in particular would not have received that type of greeting anywhere else. He would have been quickly labeled and brushed aside. Mr. Janney's character, moral, and influence meets and excels our county mission. I'm lucky to have a constant reminder that we are all equal, human, and on the same team. How true that is. So, Dwayne Janney.
Thank you.
Well, you know, it's wonderful to hear people say such wonderful things about you, and I really can't take credit for this. I suppose all of us have a favorite author, and I'm not very educated man, but I have a favorite author, and it was about 20 centuries ago that he coined the phrase, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. And my favorite author, he also said that as you have opportunity, do good to all people. And my favorite author, he went on to say, be ye kind one to another, and tender-hearted, and forgiving of others. And you know, my favorite author, he even said that we are to love our enemies and bless those that curse us and do good to them that hate us and pray for those who despitefully use us and persecute us. And I have to confess with you today that I can't live up to the standard of my favorite author. But my favorite author says if I'll confess my sin, he's faithful and just to forgive me and to cleanse me. You know, I'm ashamed to confess to you, but I've been married to the most beautiful woman for almost 34 years. And she's the sweetest and the most beautiful woman I know. She's an answered prayer in my life. But I have to confess to you that I really can't love her like I ought to. So I wonder how my favorite author could tell me to love my enemies. And my favorite author, he says that the reason why is because God so loved the people of this world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And now I know some of you already know who my favorite author is. Jesus is the author and finisher of my faith. And God forbid that I should glory, save in the cross of my Savior, Christ Jesus, my favorite author. Thank you.
Well, I just wanted to say thank you to everybody, and to say, since I've been a commissioner, I'm just continuously being impressed by the quality of the staff in county government. And you are county government. It's not the board of commissioners and the county manager, but it's you that are actually carrying out the work of county government. And it's just really so impressive. And these SOAR awards, I think you should really accept these awards as something very meaningful, because it's one thing to be recognized by whoever you report to, but it's another thing to be recognized by the people who you serve, or the people who are serving you so that you can serve your clients. You know, we're all one big team and we all have roles to play, and so serving clients is important, but so is serving those who are serving clients. It's just, I'm so impressed with this group today, and every time I come to one of these, I just feel so proud to be part of county government. So thank you for what you do. Thanks.
Thank you all very much for making time to come. These SOAR awards to me are kind of like a snapshot into county government, just a glimpse into all the lives that are being touched every day at your jobs. And it's really rewarding to hear some of the write-ups and the things that we do here. So thank y'all for making the time to come today. Congratulations to every one of you, and thank you for the work that you did. So have a great rest of the day, too.